Journal D is the new way of logging, and let's have a look how it works. As I've already explained, everything Journal D is doing is written to a binary file, and this binary file can be explored in two different ways. You can see what is happening using systemctl, but you can also see what is happening using journalctl. Now, the most important thing about JournalD is that it integrates so well with systemctl, and that means that the systemctl commands can get information from JournalD and the other way around. So let's do systemctl status of a process like NFS, for example. What you can see here is the information that it gets directly from the JournalD environment. You can also use journalctl, which is giving you the contents of the binary file the journaling is happening to. And as you can see, it's a large file, but it allows you to get anything from it that you might want to know. So let's have a look at some filtering options. Journalctl, for example, -b gives you boot information. That is one of the nice things about JournalD. It is activated immediately, so logging happens from the very first stages of operating system boot. Or what do you think of journalctl --since equals yesterday? That is a filtering option, and as it is June 13th that I'm recording this, you can see everything that has been happening since midnight on June 12th. So let's have a look at what happened on my server by using journalctl as well. So I've been working on the LDAP server, which is a SLAPD process. You don't have to know anything about the SLAPD process, but I did have some trouble setting it up, so it should be logged somewhere. To start with, systemctl status SLAPD would be a good idea. As you can see here, many messages are logged from the LDAP server. Let's make the window a little bit bigger. But you can also see that it's kind of hard to read. So let's add -l as well. So you might be thinking, this is a session about JournalD. So why is he talking about systemctl? Well, that is because systemctl and JournalD are so narrowly integrated. JournalD is basically getting its information from systemctl. And this is the basic summary of the status messages that systemctl has obtained from JournalD. So let's ask journalctl to give us some more information about a specific process. That would be journalctl -u followed by the name of the service as it is known to the systemctl system. So that would be SLAPD. As you can see, that is quite a lot of information. But even if it is quite a lot of information, the information may not be detailed enough. If you're looking for more detail, well, I've got news, good news. You can add -o verbose. So do you see that? It gives us complete information of the environment of the process and exactly everything that has been happening at the moment a message was logged. And this demonstrates how journalctl can really get detailed information out of your system.